Let me start this week's video by saying I'm sorry, Muhammad does not appear in this video. The combination of Ramadan and self-isolation provides a rational fear that it could lead to overeating. But is it a rational fear? For some reason, everybody seems to have the wrong idea about fasting in Ramadan. People think it might be unhealthy because of how much food we eat at night. They think that the big iftar meal and subsequent snacks give an individual far more calories than they actually need, therefore making you gain a bit of weight. Also, people think that because you are fasting, you should avoid all physical exercise because it's dangerous at all costs. After hearing a lot of people say they've gained weight in Ramadan, I decided to tackle the question of, does it really? In general, Ramadan fasting did not produce a detrimental effect on performing physical activities and on the energy of the individual. These are not my words. These are the words of a study conducted by the Kuwait University Health Science Center, who studied 16 sedentary adults. That means even though they haven't performed in any physical activity whatsoever during the holy month of Ramadan, they did not gain weight. Okay, so one little study doesn't really mean anything. But a similar study from the Tehran University of Medical Sciences also showed that body weight and BMI both decreased during Ramadan fasting in both genders. So we can eat whatever we want. Right? First of all, these studies take into account a healthy population. And what they don't take into account is serious and long-term illnesses like diabetes. If we look closely, we see that the studies indeed show a decrease in weight, but that decrease is only temporary. And it clearly states that the weight has been regained very quickly shortly after the passing of the holy month. So, I could weigh 80 kilos, go down to 76, and 3 weeks after Eid, go up to 85. And then I would say, oh, I gained weight because of Ramadan. Some bodybuilders might say, what about protein body mass? Science also has the answer to that question. According to research in the Indonesian International Journal of Endocrinology and Metabolism, body fat, water, and other measurements significantly decreased while protein mass did not. It also showed that there is no significant negative effect on exercising. So what's our excuse? Let's get up off our butts and move. Ramadan is all about food. Food retailers make sure that they have huge reserves and stocks a month ahead of the holy month in preparation for the huge increased demand. Supermarkets and hypermarkets extend hours to late at night and tend to have Ramadan-specific promotions and offers. Plus, every advertisement you see is about food, whether it's on TV, Twitter, Instagram, or YouTube. Despite the fact that Ramadan is a fasting month, food consumption between the time of Fatur and Sahur increases significantly. If the food consumed does not equal gained weight, where does it go? It is unfortunate, yet very true, people seem to exaggerate how much food they actually need. In Egypt, for example, it is reported that 60% of food purchased for Ramadan is wasted, which completely contradicts Ramadan's ethics and morals. After Ramadan, fridges are filled with delicious food, and then nothing holds you back. Hey. That might explain why we think we gained weight because of Ramadan. Because as soon as Ramadan is done, we eat whatever we want, all the time. It goes without saying, but it all boils down to eating habits. If the big majority of our food is nutritious and compensates for the deficit we had earlier in that day, we're all good to go. But who can resist your aunt's special Ramadan cake or the other sweets and delicious meals that are always available? I know I'm definitely guilty of being tempted by these delicious pieces of heaven. As a takeaway message, I'd like to share a way for you to track and see how well you're doing, whether it's in Ramadan or any other month. Make an Excel spreadsheet, weigh yourself every day, and track how well you're doing. If your weight is not changing, well done! You have great control. If it's changing, you know what to adjust and when to adjust it. Hopefully, it gives you a motivational boost to stay fit and stay active. Because even though studies do not show that Ramadan itself makes you gain weight, nor negatively affect your physical exercises, daily eating habits definitely do. And my wish to you in this Ramadan is to enjoy it, stay healthy, and stay safe.